every island on Earth has a unique set of plants and animals that's found nowhere else in the world. You hop on a boat, you go to the next island, and the entire ecosystem changes.
That adds to the allure of islands as these special places.
95% of all recent extinctions have occurred on islands. The biggest threats that island ecosystems are facing right now are climate change and the increasing severity and frequency of storms like hurricanes. And they're also experiencing really dramatic development.
It's a global issue, and it's one that we and our ancestors have played a role in creating, and it feels like we have to be part of the solution. There is hope for islands, both in terms of restoring habitats and reaching communities, that the Academy is well placed to have a really big impact. So all the archipelagos that are included in Islands 2030 are places where the Academy has already been working with communities for decades, sometimes even over a century.
Like the cricket farm in Madagascar, providing protein for parts of the country which are in the middle of a famine. We're able to weigh in on how to halt the loss of biodiversity, but it's not only accomplished through science, it's accomplished through science education, through environmental learning, through bringing communities and community partners together to have conversations about what their goals are.
Islands 2030 aims to reverse biodiversity loss on tropical islands by leveraging our extensive natural history collections here at the Academy, understanding which habitats are high priority for restoration or regeneration.
The Islands 2030 initiative is bringing the full strength of the Academy. We have so much expertise in this building, and we want to share that expertise in partnership with island communities, island nonprofit organizations, and island governments. And we're doing that by bringing our environmental learning programs and lessons learned from right here in San Francisco to tropical island communities to help them better understand what resources will be available to connect students directly with nature. We're bringing our biodiversity science team to really document in fine scale what populations are present and where we might need to focus more attention in order to ensure the long-term sustainability of those populations. The most exciting aspect of Islands 2030 is the people who are really doing the work, our STEM leadership cohort, who are coming here to the Academy to be trained in world-class biodiversity science and who are leading the on-the-ground work in each of their islands and each of their archipelagos. These graduate students have the power to be really transformational in their communities and for the places that they're from. I hope that when the Islands Initiative is finished, that the need for us to work in these places is finished. Not that there aren't more lessons to be learned from them, but that each of these places is thriving because we're connecting these communities with tools, with knowledge, with expertise, with leadership. Because if we can halt the loss of biodiversity, if we can create better connections between humans and nature in island communities, then those island communities will be the leaders for the rest of the world.